So I think that we're actually going to take these couple of minutes and introduce our next speaker already, because I know he has a lot of content that he wanted to share. So I will introduce our Chief Product Officer at DataTalks, Pantelis Parastatidis. Welcome, Pante. So I'll just say
Hi, hi
goodbye to
Maria.
you guys,
Can you
Peter
hear me?
and Yuri. You can drop
Bye.
off
Thank you
if
very
you
much.
want. We'll move on to the next session. So you're our Chief Product Officer, Pante, and I will let you take the stage.
Great. Thanks. Thanks a lot, Maria. And really interesting and nice discussions that we had. And it's really nice to see how sports is evolving over this tough era of the pandemic, but there are a lot of opportunities as well. So I'm Pantelis, I'm Chief Product Officer at DataTalks, and what I would like to show you and share with you and with the audience today is a demo of our product regarding an imaginary virtual sports company called Datadogs FC Football Club. What we're gonna show is how we collect data, how you can send data to the Datadogs customer data platform, how we analyze the data, how you can analyze, like with self-service analytics, the data, how you can segment your audiences, your fan base with a very nice and user-friendly way, and then how you can target your customers, your supporters by email, providing a very good and personalized communication that will allow you to increase the engagement, increase the loyalty, and of course increase the revenues. So I think we can actually share my screen, and we can go ahead with the demo. So now let's look at the demo of Datadog's CDP. So Datadog CDP, to start with, getting data into Datadog CDP, we have three ways of collecting data. That is through files, typically CSV files arriving into an SFTP server from your systems, through what we call Datadog Integrator, which means that you might have your data into third-party systems that you want to share it with Datadog CDP. And we integrate with those third-party systems to collect the data. This usually happens once per day. And the most popular and third way, it is the Datadog API. So this is a public RESTful API that we publish. You just need to integrate, authenticate with it, and you can just start sending data to this API. This is mainly the case for real-time action. So when you want to send us data in real time and act on the data, then definitely Datadog's API is the way to go. Now, Datadog has three main data points, three main entities. That is the profile, the events, and the inventory. A profile can be anything such as like a customer, a salesperson, or a vendor, or a business. It doesn't necessarily need to be one physical person, like one human. It can be as well a business in case that you want to capture B2B data in our customer data platform. Then we have the events, which is basically the actions that a profile takes in the context of your business. That can be purchases, orders, bookings, stadium visits, and so on. And then we have the inventory, which is about to describe basically mainly the events, but profiles as well. So this is like data that is very similar to a catalog, but have information about entities and attributes that are related to events and profiles. And that can be the stores, products, football matches or sports matches, stadium, seat map, or contracts and subscriptions. If we want to look a bit closer, we can see here that we have, let's say, a person as the profile. A person can have some personal details, demographic details, preferences, or other data. It is up to you to decide this. What we need from you in order to be able to integrate and send us data into our profile endpoint is that you put a unique identifier so that we can uniquely identify what is the person or the business that you are sending us data. And we need the profile type. We need to know if that is a company or if you refer to a person or if you refer to a vendor or a salesman. The reason for this is that in the Datadog CDP, you might want to do different things with different profile types. Then we have the events. This person can actually generate one or more events that are related to your business. This can be as well like a ticket purchase, or a meal purchase, or a hotel booking, a flight ticket booking, or a merchandise purchase. It's up to you, it's up to the business that you are in and the events, of course, that you are interested in. And again, here, what we require is you to tell us what is the event type. You are free to choose that. We don't have any predefined pool of events in that sense. It is up to you, and it's of course up to you to define how you're gonna describe this event. The same occurs for profile. So the attributes, if you want to bring 30 or 300 attributes to describe a profile or an event type, then this is not an issue. This is not a problem. We want we respect your data, we respect that you have quite volatile and flexible and changing data over time, so we allow you to define your data that you want to use in the customer data platform. And then the last endpoint is the inventory. So here, basically, as I said before, this has to do with items and data to describe a bit more in depth the events. So in the case of a ticket purchase, we can have, for example, the match ID, the game ID that points to a game between two teams. And here in the inventory, by looking up to this game ID, we can take a look of the teams that are participating into the game, the competition that they are competing for, the sport, and also the event date. Similar to this, if you have, let's say, a merchandise business or a retail e-commerce or physical store, then of course you have like tons of products, and those products, they have some specific characteristics, like they have a size, a color, a brand, a material, and so on. And of course, the reason that you need this data is that you want to add another angle on the analysis of your customers and what or your profiles and what they actually prefer to buy and they use to buy and what triggers them to interact with your business. So those are the three endpoints. Again, quite flexible. All we need is a unique identifier for each one of those endpoints, and also to give us an indication about what is the type of event, of profile, or inventory. You can find more information on Datadog.cc slash documentation slash data dash points. Now, if we look at the demo, as part of this session, we are going to cover the DataTalks CDP as a platform, as a customer data platform for sports organizations. And as you can see here, we are talking about a football team or soccer, how it's called in US. And we are talking about a team, an imaginary team called DataTalks FC, a football club that competes in Premier League and also in Champions League. The first thing that you see as an end user ending up in DataTalks CDP is this scorecard. This is something that it will be ready. It will be there is some charts that are going to be by default, depending on your business. Of course, they're going to be by default here, but of course you are free to change this. So we offer full self-service analytics capabilities where you can actually go in and easily change those charts, generate more or remove some that you think that they are not important, or change just existing ones. You are the one to decide about what are your most important KPIs and what do you want to see the time that you log in every day to DataTalks CDP. So what we see here and what is the user story that we will cover in order to show the demo is that we have a a sports club, a football club that has ticket sales. They compete in a Premier League and in Champions League. So on top here, we can see how the ticket sales are going based on the date or the opponent, and similar in the Champions League competition. And we have an OTT platform as well. For those that are not aware, OTT platform is a streaming platform that many teams own, which usually has, of course, a lot of video content for the of the particular team, of the particular team, backstage or videos from the training or interviews with new players. But they also have usually live games. The home games are usually streamable. You can pay per view or you can subscribe for the whole season, and you can buy and watch your favorite team game online. So here we can see, for example, an analysis of the top 10 countries that they of people that they buy and they use the OTT platform, or how it performs by country on different opponents. So maybe different opponents have different, they look different to people from different countries. And then the same occurs, of course, for the Champions League. And then we also have in-stadium purchases. So you go into the stadium and then there is a canteen that you can go and you can buy different products. It's very also interesting to see what are the products that are usually being bought, and make an analysis and plan your strategy. Again, this is not fixed data. It is up to you. If you don't have some of this data, that doesn't really matter. You can focus on other most important KPIs. We just want to show here the capabilities. Now we go into the data points, what we just talked 5 minutes ago. And the most important to look here, I think, is the profiles. And this is all your fan base, all your fans or supporters that you have them stored in your systems. It doesn't need to be in one system. It can be to more than one system. They end up here. So if we look at the profile, what we can see here, it's a very nice and detailed view of your supporter. Here we can see personal details. We can see that this person, for example, is an Instagram follower. It has the mobile app. It's not a TikTok follower, not a newsletter, a subscriber, not a YouTube follower, and not an OTT platform subscriber. And we can see the country, the gender of the male, and so on. Again, this is quite flexible for you to bring your own data and have it displayed here. Here we can see some KPIs, like the number of ticket purchases in total for this person, number of stadium visits, OTT purchases, number of in-stadium purchases, and so on. And here we can also put some analytics, some charts to show a few other KPIs that we think that they are important. Again, of course, always when we see analytics, we can just click and edit. Simply, with a nice user interface meant for people that are not like data scientists, they are just campaign managers or marketing managers, very easy to change. And here we can see, for example, the last five events of this person, like an OTT purchase or in-stadium line item purchase, and we can see here how those are defined. Again, you are free to define and bring the data that you like to describe this event. As you can see here, we have an event ID and we also have the event type, which is an OTT purchase, and that is our requirement. Then it's up to you how to describe the events. Let's look now to one of the most important functionalities of a customer data platform. So now we saw that we get to know our data, we get to know our profiles, but what we want in a customer data platform is to be able to segment people, to put them into different audiences that have people with similar preferences, similar characteristics, similar behaviors, and target them. So let's say that we want to build a segment that contains people that missed the last game. This segment contains people that have bought a season ticket. For those that don't know, season ticket is a ticket that allows you access to all the home games of your favorite team. So when we have people that have acquired a season ticket, they bought for their seat across the whole season, but they don't come into the stadium, then we want actually to send them an email and say, you know, we missed you. And by the way, if you don't attend the next game, please take a voucher code to go into the streaming platform and watch the game from the streaming platform. So then what we want to do is that we want to personalize a communication towards that person and actually target for an upsell, make this person to buy more and increase our profits. How we can do that? We start by defining the segment and we use what we call segment builder. This is a very nice and easy, I would say, SQL query, but you don't write SQL. You can use this quite user-friendly segmentation builder in order to segment your people. So we can just say what is the competition that we are talking about, and we are talking about people that have bought a season ticket, and we talk about people that bought the season ticket for the Premier League, the current season of the Premier League, because they might have bought season ticket for 2-3 seasons ago. And as you can see, we can always go and we can create more complex groups of rules. We can get it as complex as we want, but now we're gonna leave it a bit like that. And then what we can do is that we can export those profiles into a file, you know, if we want to do some kind of get the data into an Excel sheet or a Google sheet and process it in another way. One very important thing that we can do here is that we can share this data with the third-party systems. We can share this data to your marketing automation tool so that you can act and communicate to your customers, or to an advertising platform so that you can send ads to those people, or you can find lookalike audiences and target. You don't need to have all those systems. You don't need to have any of those systems if you don't like, or if you have more than those systems, we will integrate with those and you will be able to send out data here. So if we look at the ready-made example, we see that we wanted to create a segment with people that missed the last game against Brighton. So we defined here the rules, and now we can see that we have 1,200 profiles that fall into this segment, that satisfy those criteria. There are people that bought season ticket for this season's Premier League, and they missed the last game against Brighton. The next step that we want to take into this journey is to actually target, as we said, those people. And targeting by email, and also providing a personalized experience. We just don't want to send them a spam email. We just want to target them and provide a personalized experience that will make them more engaged to the sports club, to your business. They will make them more loyal, and this will turn into more profit for you. So we go here and we define the email name. That is not the subject of the email. The subject comes here. That is for you to identify what is the purpose of this email sent out. We can put the email subject here, which is "we missed you." And here we can also choose the segments to target. We can choose one or more segments to target with this email sent out. Right now we are targeting people that missed the game against Brighton. And now comes the fun part, when we have the edit email template. So this is, as you can see, a very nice user-friendly interface where you can actually, with drag and drop components, create a top-notch email template that you will send out to your customer base. So that is actually a very nice way. Of course, you can get more advanced. You can download the HTML code and configure it on your device, and then import it again. Or you can prepare the HTML code on your device and put it here if you want to make more complex designs. That is quite a flexible tool to use and create your nice email templates. And the best of it, of course, is that, as you can see here, we have a lot of dynamic fields. Okay, so we have here this, the final score against against Brighton on the last game, and we can have some statistics that we acquired through a public API from Premier League, and we can put statistics. So our idea here is that we will create a nice email saying, "Hey, we missed you on the last game. Those are the most important statistics, and by the way, enter here to get a discount code for Detox TV for the next game." So as you can see here to the right, we have quite a lot of dynamic fields that are being data is being fetched from the database to populate the email. So if we go back, and we can actually test this email. So I will send a preview to myself. You always want to do that before you send out to your customer base. And if I go here, I'm able to see my email. As you can see, those dynamic fields are now being replaced. This is a very nice personalized, it targets me. It has some stats about the last game I missed, and also it has a banner here to enter and get a discount for the next game on Datatox TV, which is the OTT platform. And the last thing that you want to do here is, of course, you are targeting now your audiences, you are sending out an email, but you want to target if your efforts are actually taking place. Okay, so we go again back to the segment and we can see analytics that are around the segment. So we can see here the open counts with the orange and the click counts with the blue, like how many people after you sent the campaign, this email, how many people opened it, how many people clicked on the link, on the voucher, and also we can see the attendance over time per segment. This actually compares if people actually came back to the stadium in the next games, and it also compares with other segments that we have created. If we want just to focus on this segment of people that missed the game against Python, we can see that the attendance is really going down. So it means that those people, they didn't attend the next games, but it goes up in a game in June. We always want to have other segments here that we created before, and we want to track how do those segments compare to each other. So that was a very short introduction of Datatox CDP. We went through how we collect the data, how Datatox expects you to send the data, how you can define your important KPIs and see. Of course, you are free to create more dashboards and analytics and build a storyline here from the database to populate the email. So if we go back and we can actually test this email, so I will send a preview to myself. You always want to do that before you send out to your customer base. And if I go here, I'm able to see my email. As you can see, those dynamic fields are now being replaced. This is a very nice personalized, it targets me. It has some stats about the last game I missed, and also it has a banner here to enter and get a discount for the next game on Datatox TV, which is the OTT platform. And the last thing that you want to do here is, of course, you are targeting now your audiences, you are sending out an email, but you want to target if your efforts are actually taking place. Okay, so we go again back to the segment and we can see analytics that are around the segment. So we can see here the open counts with the orange and the click counts with the blue, like how many people after you sent the campaign, this email, how many people opened it, how many people clicked on the link, on the voucher. And also we can see the attendance over time per segment. This actually compares if people actually came back to the stadium in the next games, and it also compares with other segments that we have created. If we want just to focus on this segment of people that missed the game against Python, we can see that the attendance is really going down. So it means that those people, they didn't attend the next games, but it goes up in a game in June. We always want to have other segments here that we created before, and we want to track how do those segments compare to each other. So that was a very short introduction of Datatox CDP. We went through how we collect the data, how Datatox expects you to send the data, how you can define your important KPIs and see, of course, you are free to create more dashboards and analytics and build a storyline here. That is just the scorecard, the homepage. We went through the profiles, how we display the data that we get, if that is like offline data or online, you know, page views and sessions on your website. And then we went through segmentation, creating audiences of people, targeting those people by using the email builder, and also tracking what impact had your actions towards your customer base. I hope that you liked the demo, and of course feel free to contact us for private demo and also for answering any of your questions.